Okay, Be'ezat Hashem, Na'aseh V'Natzliach. I would like to welcome you to another session of our weekly learning of Minchat Aharon, She'elot V'Tshuvot Minchat Aharon, written by Rabbi Aharon. Rosenfeld, also known as Harav Miyafo. He, Be'ezat Hashem, that this learning will be to the Hatzlacha of Pesi Penina Bat Brendel, Dov Shmo Ben Saraita, Aaron Ben Pesi Penina, Yehuda Ben Pesi Penina, Miriam, Shlomi, Ruchel, the children of Pesi Penina, and also Kava Bat Geula Gila for success and refuah. We'll get you on the next one. Now, as we continue our learning of the Halachot, the Rabbi has some very interesting questions. I wanted to do one about mezonot, only because we had a quick mezonot question over here. But before that, there's an interesting one. Siman Shintet, the rabbi asks, or was asked, Hausetz rachav kodem achila. Somebody goes to the bathroom before he eats. Venotela yadayim. And he washes his hands. Im yotze bezel achila. Is it enough to wash your hands one time? Four. Both netilat yadayim for food, as well as asher yatzar
for the bathroom. I've always had that question.
Excellent. Let's answer it. Tshuva b'mishna berura seif kuf samechei rotze lomar leshitat haposkim deday benetila achat.
Wow.
The mishna berura. This is not some light opinion.
Let's put it this way: if I do time, I won't get fucked.
Exactly. That it's enough. It says that it's enough that they do according to the opinion of most of the poskim, one time washing the hand is enough. Vivarech mikodem al netilat yadayim. First he does the blessing of al netilat yadayim for the food. V'achar kach asher yatzar. And after that, so the way that it would be is like this: a person goes to the bathroom, he comes out. They need to do netila. They do the netila for food. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. They say, al netilat yadayim. They do a motzi, whatever there is that they need to eat. Then they sit down and they say, and so on and so forth. ויש לסמוך על זה בדיעבד, he says, and you have an opinion that you can rely on, שכבר נתן נטילה אחת כדין, או אפילו כחתחילה שיש לו דוחק במים. He says, why can you rely on this? Because you already did a proper hand washing.
If you just wash the hands like this after...
So he says, it's because you did a proper hand washing. What's also another thing that you can rely on? What if you only have enough water for one netilat yadam? You're in the middle of a trip, you're in the desert. You went to the restroom, do you now used for asher yatzar or for food? So the rabbi is telling us, in both opinions, regardless of what the situation is, it's enough that you do it one time. ובחזון איש, סעיף חבדלת כתב, דנוהגים כאלה חתחילה ליטול נטילה אחת, ובריך הנטילה תדע, ואחר כך אשר יצר. חזון איש says, normally this is what a person should do. Which is interesting, because I find myself doing both. Like sometimes when you come back from shul, Shabbat, right before you might have to go relieve yourself, so you do that, and then minutes later you're already doing netilat yadayim, and sometimes even like right before you find yourself doing asher yatzar and then kiddush or different situations. So anyways, it shows us that it's permissible. Back to what originally we wanted to speak about. She'ela. Where is it? Here it is. Basar v'dagim shemetagnim b'shemen hanikra. This is such a hard Yiddish word. Iver got zweige nate fleisch. I don't know. Look at this.
Covered chicken breasts.
Right. So this is a breaded chicken cutlet.
Yes.
Or breaded fish. You know, like fish fillet. ועופה עשייתן שמתחילה מגלגלים הבשר הדגים בקמח, ושוב מגלגלים אותם במי ביצים. So the way that you would do it is that you put it in the flour, and then after that you put it in the egg so it binds, and then you fry it. ואחר כך מפסים להם קמח מצה, and then you put on top of it matzimil, or breadcrumbs, דק מאוד, ממש כקמח, breadcrumbs that are crushed, completed like almost as if they are flour. ושוב נותנים על האש לתוגנם בשמן. And then again you put them on the fire and you fry them. ואתה שאלה, the question is, כשאוכל הבשר או הדגים, אם ואכל עליהם בורא מיני מזונות או שהכל? Now the question is, what do you bless on that chicken cutlet? What do you bless on that fish fillet? Is it שהכל נהיה בדברו? Because it's chicken, it's fish? Or because you've put so much breadcrumbs on it and so much flour on it that the beracha changes not to mezonot. Here's the answer. בשאלות תשובות נשאל בזה ושיב ואחד מהם הדבר פשוט שצריך לברך רק שהכל ולא בורא מיני מזונות. כי החומר הנעשה מחמשת מיני דגן תפל לבשר. He says actually you only say shakol niya bidvaro and you don't say mezonot, even though that you do have flour or breadcrumbs on top of it, which is from the five grains that we say amotzi on or mezonot on. And he says why? Because there's a concept in food. When you make berachot, you have to say what's ikar, what's tafel, what is the main thing and what is secondary or subordinate. So for example, if I'm sitting on a plate, right, and I have a plate of a steak, like a steak, and I have rice, right? If the big piece of steak is the main piece, right, what do we say? We say shakol, because I have a little bit of rice around it. It's, almost like decoration. But if I have, a chicken lo mein, mm-hmm. right? A chicken fried rice, right? And inside the fried rice, I have bits of pieces of meat or bits of pieces of chicken. Yeah. You don't say shakol on the meat of the chicken. Why? Because the ikar there is the rice. So there's the inyan of ikar and batel. So over here it's saying, when you're deep frying a piece of fish or a piece of chicken, what's the ikar? The chicken or the fish? The meat or the fish? What's the tafel? The coating around it.
Or so pizza.
There's opinions. I'll tell you in a second. Let's just finish this. שהכל, ואחר כך ניקח קצת מהחום מחמש מיני דגים, ואחר בורא מיני מזונות, או להפוך מתחילה בורא מיני מזונות, ואחר כך שהכל, יש שם באריכות. He says, but if you want to be, more stringent and more careful, what you should do is take a little bit of the crumbs that's on top of it, and say, ברוך אתה השם, אלוקים מלך העולם, בורא מיני מזונות, and then take the piece and say, שהכל on it, or vice versa. You could do shakol, and then after that, take some of the stuff and just eat it as it is, as borei min mezonot. And there's much to be said on it. And the rabbi sends us to the book to look up the rest of the opinions. However, im kolef adam achomer shesaviv ha'ibir sam v'nizganat basar o dagim. It says, however, if a person takes this flour that we put, this coating that we put on top of the chicken cutlet or the fish or the meat, he takes it off ואוכלו בפני עצמו and eats it on its own, אז בוודאי מחויב לברך עליו בורא מיני מזונות מפני עצמו ועל הבשר או דגים שהכל. It says then obviously if you're separating it, for sure you have to say it. Only because we're on it, I'm going to ask, I'm going to do one more.
Pizza, and I don't know.
Not necessarily. No. They're asking over here all about a potato knish. Who's a New Yorker over here? The potato knish. What is it? It says the shela al potato knish memule betapuchei adama that is filled with potatoes. Veuneesa kemulaita bifnim tapuchei adama merusakin ubachut saviv isa ez brachav brachin. If you know the New York knishes, it's filled with mashed potato, you can say, but the outside is a hard, crunchy batter that they put on top of it that is actually mezonot, or this batter has different from potatoes. What should we do?
That's
so what do we say? תשובה, הליבה דקולה עלמה, גם לתשבץ, אין לברך אלא בורא מיני מזונות. ואם צריך להוציא את תפוחי האדמה בפנים וברך עליו בפורי האדמה, דעת כאן לא קיימת תשבט להוציא ממנית הפירות, אלא בפירות, אילן, כמו תפוח וחוצה בזה. He says that actually on that potato knish, it's מזונות. Because that is דעיקר. And not only that, he says, even if you want to be motzi, the food that's inside of it, usually we only make an inyan when it's bore peri ha'etz. We want to be motzi something that's from etz, not from adama. So he said, להוציא מהמוליטה פירות, אלא פירות אילן, כמו תפוח ויוצא בזה, החשובים ביותר, the more important, the fruits that come from the tree. אבל תפוח אדמה שאינם חשובים כל כך, but he says that the potatoes that are not so important or not so honored, בוודאי גם לדידי אין צריך להוציא תפוח אדם ולברך עליהם. So for potato knish, מזונות is enough. Okay, very good.